What is Gradle? So what is this Spring Boot? Build.gradle file. HTTP request. Hello everyone. A very warm welcome to Think Constructive. I am Isha. In this session, I will be doing Java Spring Boot project with the help of Gradle as a build tool. In my previous Spring Boot sessions, I have done the demonstration using Maven as a build tool. But now in this session, I will be doing that with a Gradle as a build tool. Because nowadays, many organizations are moving towards Gradle. So you should know how to do projects with a Gradle also. It's going to be very helpful if your organization has already moved towards Gradle or if they are planning to do that. All right, so let us quickly start with the discussion now. So what is this Spring Boot? Spring Boot is a popular Java-based web framework which makes developers' life very, very easy. It easily creates a standalone production-grade applications. It automatically configures a Spring and third-party libraries. And it comes with the Tomcat, Jetty and Undertow App servers as embedded servers. So by default, Tomcat works as the default app server, but you can always go ahead and configure Jetty and Undertow also. So these app servers are also supported. So let us understand first what is Gradle. So Gradle is an open source build automation tool that can be used to build Spring Boot applications. So in Gradle, build scripts are written and these scripts are written using Groovy or Kotlin DSL. All right. And its build file name is build.gradle. So in build.gradle file, that is the main build file for Gradle. In this file, the build scripts are written. That means the project dependencies and all other related stuffs are given in build.gradle and that will be used in order to build the project. Alright, so I'll quickly show you Gradle website also. So here we'll just give Gradle and we'll get the first link as Gradle build tool. So here in Gradle build tool, you can see a complete Gradle website. So this is the documentation hub, user manual for Gradle. So for more detailed information, just in case if you need, you can always go ahead and refer this website. Let's have a quick look on the demonstration plan for this session. So in this session, we'll be doing a project setup using a Spring Initializr in which we will be using Gradle instead of Maven. Then we will be developing REST API for a Spring Boot project that will be followed by building the project using Gradle. And the key point or key explanations of build.gradle file. And then we will be testing it using Postman and browser window. All right. So I would highly recommend you open your IntelliJ IDE editor or whichever Java editor you are using for the coding. So use that, open that editor and code along with the session or at least save the session in your watch later kind of playlist. And you can always refer back in order to build the complete project. All right. So let us quickly start with the demonstration. I'll open a Spring Initializr. Because the Spring Initializr is one wonderful way to initiate your Spring Boot project. Alright, so here in this project, Gradle Groovy is the default selection and let it be like this because we are anyways building a Gradle project. Language will remain Java. Spring Boot any version, whichever you would want, you can select. So I'm going ahead with 3.1.2. In the group, I'll just give com.thinkconstructive. All right. Artifact demo Gradle. Okay. And in description, I will write demo project for Spring Boot Gradle. Okay, because this is what we are doing. Okay, packaging, jar, and Java version, let it be 17. Okay, now in the dependency selection, since we are building REST API, so for that we would need the Spring Web. You can notice the description here, build web including RESTful applications using Spring MVC. All right, so I'll be including this dependency. Okay, and then I will quickly say generate. The moment I have generated the project, it has downloaded a zip file for me. Okay. So this zip file, you can extract and load it in the editor of your choice. Okay. In my case, I will be using IntelliJ IDE editor, okay? I have extracted and opened demo Gradle project here in the IntelliJ IDE editor at my local machine. So let us first understand what we have got. So in the SRC folder, our basic typical structure of the Spring Boot project, we have got demo Gradle application, since the name we have given to our project is demo Gradle, and Spring Boot application. So this is the starting point for our Spring Boot application. All right. Next important thing we should understand is build.gradle file. So this is the topmost important file to build any Gradle project. All right. So this file, at the starting of this file, we can notice we have got plugins block. Inside plugins block, essentially all the plugins, core plugin or community plugin, which are required by the project will be mentioned. So first one, as you can see, ID with Java is mentioned. So Java is used as a core plugin here. That is where ID with Java is mentioned. So below this, two more plugins are mentioned. So these two are essentially the community plugins. So first one, as we are using Spring Boot along with its version. And another one is the Spring Dependency Management. All right. So its version is also mentioned here. Going down, we are noticing group ID. So the group ID which we had given in our Spring Initializr, that was com.thinkconstructive. Same is mentioned here. Below that, version is mentioned. So default 0.0.1-snapshot version is given. So whatever jar we will be building for this project will be versioned as 0.0.1-snapshot. All right. Down below, you can notice Java block is mentioned because Java is the core plugin for this project. So Java block will have source compatibility, and here with source compatibility, Java version is mentioned. So since we selected in our Spring Initializr as Java 17, so same is given here. All right. Now going down, repositories block is mentioned, and in that Maven Central is given. So Gradle supports two open repositories. One is Maven Central, another one is Google Maven Central. So Maven Central is more popular, and the purpose of this to provide the open source software projects. So whatever open source repositories we will be needing for our project, that will be taken by Maven Central. So that means that will be hosted there. Now down below, dependencies block is mentioned, and this is where the dependency would go. So if you remember, we included our Spring web dependency, right? Because we will be anyways building a basic REST API for the demonstration purposes of this project. So that is where we mentioned we included web dependency. So with implementation, web dependency is mentioned, right? Which is our org or .spring-framework.boot:spring-boot-starter-web. And corresponding test implementation dependency is auto included, right? So that will be a Spring Boot starter test. All right. So down below, task named as test, and it is mentioned as use JUnit platform. Now for unit testing purposes, task name test is auto created, and by default, use JUnit platform is given here. So that means JUnit dependencies and JUnit platform stuffs will be taken here, because JUnit is the most popular unit testing framework for Java. So that is where it is given as use JUnit platform. Otherwise, other unit testing frameworks are also supported. So just in case if you want to change, you can change this use JUnit platform to the other one. All right. So this is about build.gradle file. And with the help of this build.gradle file, this complete Java Spring Boot project will be built. All right. So first thing, we will do now the Gradle sync, so that whatever dependencies are there, that can be included in the project. So we will say Gradle, and this is the sync button. So we will reload or sync the stuffs here, and we will take a look at our build window here. So in the build window, you can notice Gradle daemon is started. The tasks are being built. Okay. And now you can notice build successful. Okay. So my Gradle build is successful. That means all the tasks are done properly and things are loaded, whatever is needed. Okay. So now Gradle build is successful. And this is my Spring Boot main file from where the Spring Boot application will start. So in order to have a REST API demonstration, let us start including a basic REST API file here. Okay. So I'll just add a Java class. And let's say I will call it as employee API. Okay. And the file is here. So first of all, I will annotate this class as REST controller. Before that, I think a bit spelling correction is needed. So let me just do a refactor and then I will say rename. Okay. So I'll just correct. Okay. So So I will annotate this class as REST controller. Okay. So this class will now be treated as a REST class. That means this class will be used for exposing REST endpoints. And then I will also mention the context path. So a good context path will give. So since we are building employee API, so I will just mention slash employee. All right. So this is my REST controller. And inside this, let us now write an API. So let us now quickly expose an endpoint for get employee. So I'll just say a public method, which will return string, and we'll say get employee. Okay. And this get employee, let's say accepts string employee ID. Yeah. And from here, we will return employee found. All right. So I have written my get employee method. Now I should annotate it with get mapping. Then only it can expose the endpoints. All right. So I will just say get mapping. And inside this, let's say I would say AMP ID. Okay. Fine. So how the context path will be built? Employee slash employee ID. Okay. I should close this bracket here. Fine. That's how it will be. If you are looking forward for more detailed explanation for Spring Boot and REST API, more detailing, there is a complete project tutorial available in the channel and details are getting displayed on the screens right now. Links are also tagged in the tag section above as well as in the description box below. So feel free to explore those tutorials for more deeper understanding of Spring Boot REST API. So entire detailed description along with the demonstration project, a complete CRUD project is available. So you can go ahead, watch that. That will really, really be very much helpful for you. All right. What we have done, we have defined our get employee. So how will we query that? Slash employee ID. All right. So what will I do next? I will bring up the application and see what we are expecting. Is that happening or not? So I'll just say run a Spring Boot application. And you can see here in the log window, my Gradle daemon is starting, all the tasks are getting completed, and now the Spring application is, rather the Spring Boot application has come up. Here in the log, you can see Tomcat started on port 8080, which is a default port for any Spring Boot application. So by default, a Spring Boot application will use Tomcat as app server and will use 8080 as a port. Okay. So my application is up and running on port 8080. And since I have bring up the application on my local machine, so my host will be localhost. Okay. So I'll open the browser window now. So here is the browser window. And here what we'll do, we will say http://localhost:8080/employee/ let's say 1, because whatever number employee ID I'll be giving, it will be returning me a fixed response because that's how I have coded. It will just always return the fixed response employee pound. I'll just say enter. Can you notice what I have done? I have just typed wrongly the 9. So that is where it has started looking elsewhere. So I'll just keep http://localhost:8080/employee/1. Enter. What am I getting? Employee found. Okay. Let us go back to IntelliJ and see what we have done. In employee API, you can notice we are returning response as employee found. In any case, this API will be returning this response only. Okay. So what are we getting? Employee found. This is what we were expecting. Correct? Let us test the same API with Postman also. So here is a Postman. This is another tool to test APIs, and it's a wonderful tool. So here in Postman, I will say new HTTP request, because REST API works over HTTP. Method will be get only, because we are testing our get API. And I'll go back to browser window. I'll copy this URL. Okay. And I'll put that URL in Postman. All right. And I'll hit send. I've got the same response, employee found. So that's how you can do testing with the help of Postman also. So this was the agenda for demonstration. So we have done the project setup, development for the REST API, building the project using Gradle, and testing the API using Postman and browser. All right. So let us see what all we have covered in this session. We discussed what is a Spring Boot and what is Gradle. We also checked the Gradle documentation section. We have developed the project using a Spring Boot and Gradle. And finally, we tested the project using Postman and browser, both ways. All right. Thank you everyone for watching this session. I hope you found it useful and you are now able to build your Java Spring Boot application with the help of Gradle build tool. I would also like to inform you that there are many more Java, Spring Boot and microservices sessions available on this channel. So feel free to explore them, and their respective GitHub repositories are also available. So explore them as well. Also, if you like the session, hit the like button, share the session details with your family, friends and colleagues, and leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you once again. See you in the next session. Bye for now.